Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this video, we want to run some tests on a React Native project using CodeMagic, and if the tests pass, we will build the app automatically. First of all, thank you to CodeMagic for supporting this channel, as well as the excellent CI/CD services they provide for mobile projects. On this site, you can do CI/CD for mobile apps on any platform. You can do all the testing, building, and publishing of the app in the stores automatically in the dedicated CodeMagic panel. The source code of your project in any repository such as GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket, and the like, you can connect it to this system. You can choose to build on Mac or Linux operating system. You can do your tests automatically before each build, and you can also test on emulators or real devices. You can follow the feedback for each build in Slack and share it with your team. You can upload them to stores automatically after each build and save your time. Well, now let's review the types of tests in React Native. In the testing section of the React Native document, the types of automatic tests are described. It's always better to do automatic tests before releasing the app, so that if they are failed, we will solve the problem first, and if all the tests are passed, we will release the app. The first type that I explain is unit test. Unit tests cover the smallest parts of code, like individual functions or classes. For example, in a class, we can test the performance of all functions separately to check only the function that has an error. Mocking is one of the things we can use in unit tests. Sometimes when your tested objects have external dependencies, you'll want to mock them out. Mocking is when you replace some dependency of your code with your own implementation. Jest comes with support for mocking from function level all the way to module level mocking. In integration testing, real individual units are combined and tested together to ensure that their cooperation works as expected. This means that they may work well on their own, but they will make mistakes when combined. Component tests are written to correct the performance of a component, such as a button or text input. Component tests could fall into both unit and integration testing. But because they are such a core part of React Native, we'll cover them separately. There are two ways we can test a component. Testing user interactions, which tests user action on a component, such as pressing a button. And testing rendered output, which is one of the implementation methods of snapshot tests, which actually has the task of testing the accuracy of rendering the appearance of the component in the UI. And finally, the end-to-end tests, where you actually test the app's performance on an emulator or real device from the user's point of view. Detox and Appium are the best frameworks for this method of testing. Well, I have created a simple project here that shows the user a few simple components on one page. I have also uploaded this project in GitHub, so that we can run tests and build from source code. Here in the tests folder, I have already written two tests, one of which tests the correct rendering of the app page. The other tests only one flatlist component in terms of rendering in the UI, and both of these tests are tested as snapshots. We also have a simple function here that returns the sum of two inputs. And for that function, I have written a test that I expect to be the sum of two inputs. In fact, I expect the right amount and the test must be passed. Well, now I run the app first to make sure it works properly in the emulator. And as you can see, the app ran properly. Now I run the tests to see the result. In this project, we have used Jest for testing. So make sure these values are applied in the package.json file. Well, as you can see, all three tests is passed successfully. Now, if I change the expected value in this test to a wrong value, the test must fail. And as you can see, this test is failed. Now, even though one of our project tests has been failed, if we inadvertently build the app, it will be done without error. But in fact, the function of the app will have an error. As you can see, APK files have been successfully created in this pass. Well, I will commit and push the changes so that we can continue working from the repository and throw code magic. Now I want to connect the project repository in GitHub to CodeMagic. First, sign up or log in from this section. And we can do this directly through GitHub, Bitbucket, or GitLab, or using email. I have already imported the project here, but if you want to add a new project, you can add the repository you want through this button. In this section, if you don't find the project in the Git, you can use this link to log into your Git account again and select the desired repository, which I have already done here. Then you see your project here, and after selecting the React Native App option, you can add it. Well, after adding the project, we enter its settings, and here you see a file called codemagic.yaml. The content of this file is actually read from our project, and I have already added it to the root of the project. According to the CodeMagic document and the Building a React Native App section, you can see how to fill in the YAML file settings for Android and iOS. And in this section, you can see how to perform the tests correctly. Here's how to run a unit test in React Native using Jest. Well, now let's have a brief overview of YAML file settings. In the workflow, I have entered the settings for the Android build. This name will display it to you when you select the workflow for the build. Here you can specify whether the build is done on a Mac or Linux operating system. Here we have defined the variables that we will use in this file. Things like the key store profile that should be kept private can be encrypted. You can use this button to do this. Enter the value of the variable here, and use this button to get the encrypted value, and replace it with the original value of the variable. In this section, we have the scripts that run in the same order. First, we install the dependencies using npm. Then, specify the location of the Android SDK. Then we set the key store specification according to the variables we defined at the beginning of the file. Then we run the tests. And if the tests are successful, we will release the Android app. To do this, first enter the Android folder and run this command to create APK files. Also, if you get an error requesting a permission to run the Gradle while running this section, you can use this command before running the Gradle. Finally, you can specify the output address of the APK. Whenever you make a change in the project files, you can use this update button. And according to the branch you want to build from, do this build by clicking this button and selecting the desired workflow name, which is React Native Android for this project. Well, the build process started. I will show you this process quickly, so that you only know the steps to do it. Well, as you can see, we have an error in the test phase, and the build process has stopped. One of the tests has been failed, and as you can see, because all the tests have not been passed, the next step, the release, has not been done. We deliberately failed this test, so we return it to the previous state to pass correctly. I will commit and push this change to update the repository. Now back to CodeMagic and update the project. And we do a new build again. Well, as you can see, this time all the tests is passed successfully, and we entered the release app step. Well, the release was successful. If in the YAML file, you have also made the settings related to publishing the app in the store, here the app will be published automatically. In this section, you can see the latest builds. And separately for each step, you can see the created logs. Or download their full log using this button. So there we go, we learned how to use CodeMagic to automatically run tests on a React Native project, and if all tests are passed, finally release the app or publish it to the store. Now if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.